Go ahead.
All right. Back to our normal class, or so we hope. Wednesday night, February 9th. Then Rosh Chodesh. All right. Ruth Lebanat Bat Julia. The news that was brought to my attention by David Batesh regarding a Mohel here in New York who supposedly transmitted herpes to an infant through the act of Mezizah. Mezizah is part of the Milah process. And obviously, there's a big stink in the news based upon any news search you can do through Google, you know, searching Mohel and herpes, and you'll see all types of problems going on out there, from self-hating Jews that want to do away with Mila entirely, other Jews and doctors who feel that Mezizah needs to be done away with or be done in a different fashion. And for some reason, it looks like it's a new topic in the news, but it's not a new topic. It's something that has been discussed by the Hachamim and within the medical profession going back at least 100 plus years. As I mentioned before, there was a book published in 1900 in London called Dam Berit. It was put out by the chief Mohel of London at the time, Alexander Tertis, and he made a device to alleviate the problem of the Mezizah. It worked like a siphon. Jimmy?
Was it like a tube?
Not a tube, no. It was an actual siphon. I'll show you a picture of it. Like a siphon to suck out that excess blood from that area so the Mohel wouldn't have to use his mouth. And so you're doing things in their hygienic condition. Many rabbis and doctors wrote back and forth to him about this issue, and he published all these items in a book, basically all the positive things, none of the negative. And the negative doesn't seem like there were too many based upon the articles that you read in there by the different rabbis, because they refer to the negatives, and the negatives seem to be very, very few. And anybody that commented on the negatives showed how the negatives really didn't have a leg to stand upon. So the Teshubah I decided to do is by Rabbi Rafael Harun ben Shimon, who was the chief rabbi of Egypt at the time. And it seems from this book, Dambari, the only Sefer Adi that happened to write to him on the subject, but also the longest article in the book. Okay, it's about 15 pages.
We seem to be very long-winded.
Not that we're long-winded, we're very thorough. No, we're very, very thorough. And the Mohel Tertis over here seems to have been thrilled by this Teshuvah, that he keeps referring to it and to points that Rabbi Rafael Aharon ben Shimon made throughout this book. Rafael Aharon ben Shimon reprinted this particular Teshuvah in his own work, Umisur Devash, in 1912, but I decided to print it here from the original. It's easier to read. Okay. שלום ברכה וטובה וחיים טובים וארוכים וסובע שמחות ומנומי הסלחות יחולו לראש הבני המופלג בתורה ויראה מתעשה בקודשים כבוד מורנו הרב אלכסנדר טרטיס ישמרו שלו וגואלו מוהל הראשי אשר בקהל קדוש לונדון יגן עליה אלוהים תה השם תשמרהו כן יהי רצון אמן. Very nice opening introduction, typical of ספרדים. חכם לבב בשבוע החולף הודעתי במכתב גלוי כי הנני נדרש לשאלתו בדבר הסכמת ההיתר למסוס בקרי על ידי המכונה שהמסיא כמודו לזה. You wrote to me about a week ago, I got your letter. You want my approbation on this mechanism that you created, this machine that you've made to forego Mezizah by mouth and to use this, you know, apparatus instead.
Is it electric or is it...
No, it's not electric. Seems like, I'll show you the picture in a minute. It seems like just a bulb and a suctioning tube.
Yeah, suction.
That's it. והיום הזה אני שולח את פסק דין אשר העליתי במסודת עניות שכלי הקטן. And so I'm sending to you the פסק דין that I wrote with the tiny bit of intellect that I have. תקף כאשר נגמר עתקתו בכתב ראשי להקל עבודת המסדר דבוס. I wrote it first, and then I rewrote it in a way that you can read it, because Sefer Adim write in Hasikul Mos. which is a different style of writing. מגוף פסק דין הנזכה לעיל יובן נכבודו מה יקר בעיניי לעשות עשונו. From the text that you see that I've written to you, you will understand how dear of a subject it is to do your, you know, to do your bidding and to write to you. שעמרו בעול הסיבור המוטל על סברי, that with all the burden of the congregation that I have upon myself, פניתי כמעט I grabbed little moments of time that didn't even belong to me to study this issue at length. And I touched upon all aspects of this war. Whether it regards the issue of the total annulment of Mezizah, pain the hochiyah shehi mishum sakana, or to prove that it's done because of sakana, velo mishum mizvah leba, and not only because of mizvah, gam beheter ha-mesisah mekona, also the allowance of using a instrument to do the mesisah, v'dahiti kol habbaim aliyah kenigda b'ta'anat minhag, and I pushed away everybody who came out against using a machine, and you know, and the whole argument was say, well, minhag, we never use anything, so we can't use anything now. Or hilul shabbat, or they say there's a hilul shabbat involved. I pushed those away too. Bechulei, vechol pesach din hu kashur ze bazeh, and my entire pesach din is intertwined into each other, and you will see how it flows. Vechol se'if ma shelosha se'ifim shel kelalut pesach hu nisrach lehabero v'lo yiparim minnu. Every one of the three portions of Pesach is reliant upon the other portions, and they cannot be separated one from the other. And this is one request that I have from you. If it is too long to print the entire Pesach din the way I have it, ולא יברור מה שמגיע אליו מהיתר מכונה ויידי השם פני חוטה דפוס, and you only want to write that I allowed it, you know, without writing my whole thing, you know, because it costs you too much to print. כי כל סעיף לבדולי מעשה בו כל טעמי סלדי היתר, and if you're only going to pick and choose some lines here and there to put it together, you're going to lose the whole thing. Not only are you going to lose the whole thing, ויהיו הדברים תפילים בלי מלח, the thing is going to be tasteless, with, like without seasoning. ואם and if you don't want to, if you only want to pick the things that you like, your own choosing, please return the entire thing to me at my own expense. I will pay you to return it to me. Don't do anything with it. Just ignore it. Make you believe I never sent it to you at all. And I'll write you a different, you know, short haskama, few lines, and that's it. Without bringing any, you know, sources to prove my point from the poskim. And that will not call you, cost you much at all. If that's what you want to do. Please, I went to the trouble of doing this, you know, and it costs a lot of money for me to write it over for you, and if you don't want to do it, don't worry, I don't want to lose the, you know, the beauty of the points over here. But this is only publishing part of it. And then if you only print a portion of it, then people are going to read it. Ah, oh, he's wrong about this, he didn't mention this, what about this, what about that? The people are going to think that, you know, this is all that I wrote and I don't know more than that. And as I was rewriting it from Hasid Kulmos to Rashi, a lot of new ideas came to my mind and I put those in. In the journal called the Yehudi. And I saw that you're in a rush to get this done, you know, and I sent everything to you. I have the aspiration that you are actually going to print this with other works. Okay? Either you're going to print it, or, you know, if not, give it back to me, I'm going to print it. Just mention to me that you did receive it, that even if it's just through a postcard, to put my heart at rest, that everything arrived at the right place. Shalom Rav, Bechol Tov Sela, Rosh Ma'alat Yididinu Rabbani HaMuflag, Hacham Neba Bechol Lek, Kibon Moneh HaRab, Alexander Tertus, Yishmeno Sol Golo, Mohel HaRashi B'London, Yishmeno Sol Golo, Ata Hashem Tishmerehu, Kedwa Attahor, Kibati Bissiluf HaGalyon, Oam Miktava Ayat Yehudi, Hashem Bo Yish Alani La Havod Ati Benyan Mesisat Mila, Hashem Elhamta Nifusa Ata Bisleha Chukma, Bekirb Hachmi Yisrael, Mehem Nekdeha, Mehem Mahzikeha, So now I received your letter that you sent me about a very, pertinent subject that is really causing a major stir among the Hachamim, among the Hachamim of the world and the Hachamim of Israel. Those that are pro, those that are against. And we can basically break them up into three sections. Harishon, Resona, Bitulam Mesisa Kulikar. וזאת עשת איזה רופאים אשר אמרו שעתה אין סורך בה כל עקר ונהפוך הוא שיש בה סכנה לתינוק מסיבה תחל ואי המוהל המוסס ממכן יחפשו לעוקרה משורש ואפס המס First group, get rid of mesisa of this sucking altogether. And this seems to be the advice of the doctors. They're saying nowadays there is no reason for it whatsoever, and not only there's no reason for it, but it has turned into a major danger for the infant because of the illnesses that the mohel, the moses, bears upon himself, and they want to totally eradicate it and uplift it from its roots. Hesheni, second group, hem mahazikim ba. עד כסי האחרון בלתי שום שינוי מטעם הסכנה ויש שטעמה משום מזווה ויש משום מנהג אבותינו ובכללם לא ישנו ממנה גם כקוסה של יוד Second group, totally other extreme and that they are holding on to it full force all the way we cannot change, don't tell me anything about sakana this is our minhag, this is our mizvah, and we cannot change it now, even one iota.
No tool, though. This is the one that's no tool.
Yeah, no tool. Cannot change it. That's it. This is what we use our mouth to suck, and that is it.
First group is a reform. First group is
reform. That issue of reform. We're talking about...
It's more doctors.
Yeah, it's scientific.
It's more scientific.
Fine, but you had orthodox people...
But is it halakhically saying, in other words,
halakhically speaking... He wasn't getting into the reform issue at all, From his, as we saw from other Teshubah that we've done in the past, the Hachamim or the Sefaradim at that period, reform was not even an issue that they even alluded to because it wasn't something happening to them. Either something works on Pialacha or it doesn't work on Pialacha. They weren't influenced by issues of reform, conservative, orthodox.
Approaching it from the Sakana point of view.
Right.
Because they're telling you that it's Sakana, the doctor. Right, so...
So we're going to see how he's going to approach it.
Well, what interested me is that because it said nowadays, it's a Sakana. What made it for thousands of years not a Sakana?
Nobody said it wasn't a Sakana. Microbes... Microbiology was understood a lot better in 1900 than it was in 900.
Right. So they're saying that the same rate of deaths was happening because of whatever...
Right, but basically they thought that this was, Gizirah of Hashem, or it was Shedim that came and got involved, or they didn't read the Zohar the right way, and,
You're assuming it's the baby that has the sickness, not the...
Not the mohel that trans,
Transmits it.
Right.
Okay.
You didn't read the Zohar the right way?
Maybe. Okay. Hashir Yishit, he had Di'ah Musa'at. This is the middle of the road. The path that looks at both sides. Ashalot Ahpos, Bibituham Mesisa, Mitama Sakanaham, Murab, the Brea, Botinzaham Bacha. Haumnam, Hosheshim Gamma Sakana, Hamehudeshit Alpi Adwiotar of Im. Missibat Holi, the Pam Moses. Vimkan, Resonam, Shalotiham Mesisa, the pair, Rakbukeri, Puain, Piawulat and Mesisa. Meshalazi, Himsiki Bodoshi, Ahye, Mehunat Mesisa. פועלת פעולת המסיסה בפה ממש. אם כן, שאל כבודו מאיתי להגיד לו דעתי גם אני, וכבודו שיחיה, העריך בדבר ככתוב בהקובס, לכן זאת היא תמצית שאלתו. And so the third group is the middle, that they don't want to get rid of מסיסה, because we know the Hachamim, when they talk about מסיסה in the Gemara, they also talk about סכנה. And that's why they instituted מסיסה. So, you know, there is no, you know, infected blood clot happening over there. Okay, that's part of the mitzvah, because you want to suck out. If you, let's say you got a bad cut on your hand, right away you go and you like try to suck out whatever's there, so nothing, you know, no germs and no bacterial infection get caught up into your bloodstream. That's part of what's going on over here. You made an incision, so you want to make sure nothing's going to happen, so you suck out anything. So the Hanim of the Gemara were aware of something going on, so they wanted to suck it out. That's why one of the reasons they instituted the mitzvah.
Right, it's pretty amazing that they have that understanding.
Mm-hmm. Well, they did have it. The Gemara was very clear.
Right.
Also, but these people, they don't want to get rid of Mishisah because they understand the Hachamim. At the same time, we're concerned about new testimony from the doctors about what's going on and that diseases can be transmitted from the pit, from the mouth of the person doing the sucking. So, what seems to be going on here, well, we can't get rid of Mishisah, but we don't want Mishisah by mouth. We need to have some sort of instrument to do the Mesisah that will do Mesisah in the exact same fashion as if we were using the mouth. And therefore, you, dear sir, that I'm writing this to, you created such a mechanism, you created this machine for it, that does the Mesisah the right way, and you asked me to express my opinion. And this is basically what you wrote, and I'm gonna get into it.
Page and a half before you got there.
Okay, this is the abridged form of your question. Now here's my answer, which is not abridged. Adon Nechvad. Dear sir. Hashayla Azot, Shekibodom Messiah, if I had a dun Ali Halo Hadashahi. This is wheat that has been milled so many times before. In the previous generation, the Hachamim have dealt with this. This is not the new subject that nobody ever answered before. You can go find answers, and you even mention things, and you look at the Ma'asef that comes out from Yerushalayim, from Hachem Ben Sion Pointa, and you'll see that that this issue was dealt with by so many different Hachamim. They always just want another opinion, another guy to just throw his name on the thing, on the bandwagon for yourself. But still, I felt something is correct over here, and I didn't want to, turn you away empty-handed. כי עלינו חובה לעזור על ידו באשר כבודו שיחיה תורח בדבר העומד ברום קדושת האומה. But I see that you are sincerely trying to do something to raise the level of kedusha of our Jewish nation. וברית יהדותה, and of the ברית of our יהדות. והנני נדרש של התורה. Therefore I'm coming, to answer your question. להורות לו דעתי הקטנה, כפי מה שהורוני מן השמיים. I'm going to give you whatever feeble answer I come up with based upon what they have, granted me from the Shalayim. מאוד הייתי חפש לראות את כל שקלה וטריה הנתפס מהסף הסכיל לעין. אכן, אין לי עניין שלי ממנו, כי רק איזה נומרו. אוקיי?
איזה
נומרו?
נומרו.
I only have some volumes, because I don't have all the massives. I only have some issues.
You have them?
All of the massives? No. I have some.
You have this issue?
I have some numerals. Okay? You like this numeral.
I love it.
Where came from? I was on that Spanish.
They deal with this particular issue? I never looked if they deal with this issue.
Because maybe you have it.
Yes, so if I have it.
I don't know.
We have enough to read now.
Okay.
Ask Ezra.
Simple opinion. Humble opinion.
מקוט עין יש לי שאלה שלישי וריביעי ולא כל החברות המדברים בעניין זה חסרים לי. I have some of the issues from year 3 and year 4, but most of the pamphlets that deal with this issue are missing. ומסיבה זאת כמעט גמרתי בדעתי לסגל אחור. You know, because of that I said I have to start walking backwards. ופני יהיו בכלל לבריהם דבריי. Maybe some of the things I said they already said over there. וחזק מדעתי זאת. And I said, you know what, I can't do it like that way. I'm not coming to bash other people and to come against what they have to say or looking for them to come against me. I'm not telling people, no, you are forced to accept my opinion because this is what I said. Okay, this is what I'm going to say based upon my own judgment. Whatever I've been able to study in the Anyan and come up with, that's what I'm going to say. That's what I'm going to come up and that's what I'm going to say. And thank God I know from my own experience because I'm a mohel since I'm a kid. Okay, so I'm very young. And I am practically an expert in this field. I'll call a hat mehadiyot in his kron the ayil, and I'm going to come and answer each one and every point that's mentioned above. Neshaloshet mahlokot ehem, each, you know, based upon the three different arguments. Me'aleim otof le'ati, ve'ashim yi'i azri v'shu'ati. Alif. Bi'anyan b'tulham mesisa. In the Mesisa dealing with the issue of getting rid of mesisa. הסברה הזאת היא דעת איזה רופאים חדשים מקרוב ואחריהם החזיקו גם את תופסי התורה באומרם כי אין בה סורך עתה בזמן הזה כי אין בה סכנה וחיוזה Now this issue of annulment of mesisa is something that certain doctors have come up with and after that there are, you know, some Jews who hold on to the Torah and they say, you know what, the doctors are right. What's the point? We don't need this Mesisa nowadays. This Sakana is not there. Let's get rid of it. ולדעתי הדבר ברור כי הרופאים האלה לא ירדו לדעת רבותינו זכרונן ברכה שיסדוה. I think it's very clear to me that these doctors did not actually see what the Hachamim said and why the Hachamim established it. They didn't understand. How can you say there's no purpose for it nowadays? And they can call themselves people that speak in the name of medicine. Basically, they're like spitting on their own faces. If they understand anything about medicine, they'll know that it isn't necessarily is a necessary object to, you know, to suck away the blood, you know, to prevent any sort of infection from traveling further in. And I will explain that very clearly, he says.
But they're basing it on the fact that they do it. Meaning, if they do the berit milah, there's no sakana. The way we would do a circumcision as a doctor, per se, using the implement, you know, whatever it is that we do and the way we do it, would probably be, there is no sakana, there's no need for mesisa. So, as far as the mohel goes...
Oh, כי אתה יבוא שלומר שאין בה סורך במעשה וחוכמת הרפואה שבשמו בשמה התאמרו היא עשמה תחישב תפחת ביניהם כאשר בעי בהר השם ברך הנה רבותינו זכרונם ברכה אמו בשבת אמר פפה היי אמנה דלמי יש סכנהו ומעבירינן לה Okay, so we have the Gemara on Masechet Shabbat. Rabbi says this guy, you know, is doing the Milah, and he doesn't do Mezizah. It's a Sakana, and we, what do you call it? We remove him from his position. Rashi Sham Mishnah, Dibur HaMechim Mosisin, Ketab, position on what Rashi comment, Mosisin Taddam. We suck the blood. Vafalgev, Dihi, Asiyat Habura, شين الدم تاك محبورو إلا على يديها مصيصة عاد كان شونو so how does Rashi explain it we suck the blood ويعفى الجاب هي عسيد حبورا and even though this is like bringing it together شين الدم تاك محبورو the blood doesn't separate from its partner إلا على يديها مصيصة the only way to separate blood from other blood is by actually sucking it out that's what he's saying over there You're looking at me like I'm crazy, Ronnie. Talk to me.
I don't understand.
Okay, he's going to tell you right now. The Hamuban. And what do we understand? The purpose. What are we getting out of the Mishisah? To pull the blood and to stir it, to awaken it. To pull it away from the further ends. So it does not hurt the child afterwards. When you make an incision, you cut something, all of a sudden, you know, what happened with the blood? All of a sudden you'll have the white blood cells coming over there to close up the wound, the red blood cells are pushing away, anything that may have been cut, any dirt that may have been there, whether it was on the blade or on the skin or whatever reason was in the air and fell down at that point, is going to get pulled away with red blood cells while the white blood cells are coming to fight. You know, so this, this item that's a foreign particle that can go into the bloodstream, that can create an infection later on, but it's going to go into your blood. So you're doing the Mishisa, you're sucking it, so you pull it so it doesn't go far away. And who is greater in Torah and in Rifu'ah, like our Rabbi Harambam? והוא, זיכרון וברכה, פסק בהלכות מילה, פרק בית, דין בית, וזה לשונו, what did he say? ואחר כך מוסס את המילה, עד שיעשה הדם ממקומות רחוקים, כדי שלא יבוא לידי סכנה. וכן פסק מרן, ביורי דעה, סימן יוד, רש, סעיף דלת, מיעוין שם. באופן כתב חיוב המסיסה הוא למשוך הדם ממוקירה שהוא נחבא מהם. You're pulling the blood, you're sucking it to pull it away from the areas where it's going to go hide. להוציאו החוסה, to pull it outside. ובית תועליות נשיג מזה. And two purposes we are getting from this. האחת שעל ידי המסיסה ימנע ההתלהבות והדלקה מחס המכה על ידי חום הדם שיעשה אחר כך. You are preventing some sort of infection from happening from the heat of the blood that is happening over there. ושני שעל ידי המסיסה נשיג תועלת אחריה שלו יזוב עוד דם תינוק. So what you call also, by doing that, you're also stopping the blood from flowing. כי בחוזק המסיסה, through strength, the force of the sucking, והמשיכה, יסגרו גידי הדם ולא יזובו עוד. You are causing these blood vessels in the skin itself to contract so it bleeds less. אלהם שתי פעולות המסיסה. These are the two actions of the מסיסה, הידועים לכל מוהל מומחה ובקי במלאכתו. Any expert מוהל is very very familiar with this system. ועתה, שענה את פי הרופאים המתחכמים האלה. Now let's go ask these great wise doctors. האומרים לבטל המסיסה. They want to totally eradicate and annul the Mesisa. Ken basurah, because there's no purpose for it. Naim himma bilfu'atam hayyum ina murim ken. Oh, haim yachishu zot shibichol ebr me ebareha adam miyachtach. him in Mesisat Mekum Hayatech Munat Lehabu Vedek Makah Makum Pesa Hanekab Shonam inflammation. Don't you have inflammation telling you if you don't do Mesisa, if some, you know, you open up any, you know, scout book, tell you if you get a snake bite right away, you're sucking at the blood. Of course, you're sucking, you spit it out. You want to keep away the thing. It's common practice. This is what the medical practice teaches you. Some doctors go against their own, you know, their own teachings. And this is the common practice of medicine for any part of the body. Why is this part of the body any different than any part of the body that's going to hurt this part of the body, but it helps every other part of the body? Because I'm a male, do I lose out? I don't understand. If every doctor till today says the same thing, how could these doctors come and say, no, times have changed, we don't need to do Mesisa over here? Obviously, they didn't understand what the Mesisa is being done for. They thought maybe it's done for some other ancient medical reason. Thank you. כי בחוכמת הרפואה היום יכלו למסור רפואה יותר טובה מאותה רפואה שפועלת המשיסה לפי דעתם. Maybe it's coming to do some other sort of, you know, some other medical reason behind it, and they'll find a better, more established, you know, modern medical technique for it. Well, if they understand that this is the reason for the Mesisa, and it's the same reason that they tell you to suck out blood from any other part of the body if something like this happens, then of course they're gonna, you know, they're gonna say, of course, it's the right thing to do. Okay, hashbu lehefich shepi'ulata la'asol adda. Maybe they thought we're doing it to stop the blood. And maybe they think it was just to stop the blood and nothing else. And since we know that the sucking of the blood is because of sakana, and this reasoning stands, you know, full well till today. Take a million opinions of a thousand doctors, they're going to say that. Obviously, it's going to fall, you know, when you weigh it against the opinion of the Hachamim. Because the opinion of the Hachamim still stands, and it goes hand in hand with modern medicine. And it's forbidden for us to listen to these doctors to totally eradicate Mesisah. As long as they didn't understand the reasoning for it. Because the doctors themselves do Mesisah nowadays. And how can they, you know, contradict themselves? Keep negdeham mesisa asmam, hev nishmaltim, mizavit zo, zavit aheret. Kilo masu yezot hazak the mud ala migdal hinagutam, minin bayet amam, mesitirat rayotehem, ahad la ahad, ma'azat shemit barach. Adif, bayim betaana betula. محاشا سكنات التينوك من مسيسة مسيبات موهلة موسيسة من وقع بإذ محلة بالدباكت ويدبيك محلاته التينوك النمصاص. Okay, they come with their reasoning to stop the Mesisa. Why? They're concerned. They're worried for the baby because the Mesisa, like David was saying a minute ago, that maybe the Mohel has some sort of disease, some sort of illness that is contagious, and he's going to cause that contagious disease to move from his mouth to transmit, thank you, to the baby itself, through the bloodstream of the baby. ואין בכוחם נחיש תועלת המסיסה ביחס עצמה, רק יחששו לסכנת תינוק מסת המוסס. לא שכחדו תועלת המסיסה למסס. They're not saying that they bring a different point. They're not saying there's a problem with Mezizah itself. They have a problem with something being transmitted from
the doctor,
from the Moher. But they don't have a problem with the Mezizah. V'yehachi te'eman etme adehim. We have to be surprised. So if you have a problem with the person himself who's doing the sucking, why get rid of the Mezizah? Keep Mezizah a different way. Or, you know, or get rid of the person sucking, whatever the case may be. Not every Mohel has a contagious disease. So why do away with Mezizah totally? Obviously, if we think we have any reason, any cause to believe that there is a disease, any sakana, then of course we have to distance ourselves from such a thing. And obviously, there is a way to correct this, as we will explain in the third Sa'if. This is not our way to push off one sakana because of a different sakana. They want to do, and it's not just. To totally eradicate Mezizah, this is something that we cannot hear. We have to get rid of the problem, but we cannot get rid of Mezizah itself.
Sil harim ra'uke harim. So the shadows of the mountains, they seem like mountains. Oh, that is that because this was very big? They found support to their bitul according to their opinion, right?
That has no necessity
based on this the rehisa of the hot water, right? The washing of the hot water to the baby on Shabbat was nullified. Shebizman hashaz haya ha'adara lesakana ve'ata in sakana ve'nitbatela. Right, v'hu hadin le'mesisa. Oh, but so they actually did some research, these doctors. That's what he's claiming.
They did research.
Okay. Right. So during the time of the Talmud, this danger disappeared, right? And so
there used to be an opinion, a thought in the time,
right,
in the ancient time, that you have to wash the baby with hot water, right?
Right.
And even on Shabbat, you have to wash the baby with hot water.
Right.
And the Hachamim decided there's no more sakana involved, this needs to be done. And so therefore, they annulled it, based upon the science of their times in the Gemara. So now these medical doctors of the time are saying, well, see, even the Hachamim knew when, you know, circumstances change, you annul it. So over here also, this needs to be annulled now. Right. There's no purpose for it.
Chodo shehiye bigilayon dalit. Mehakobes hanitpas b'yehudi. השיב שענה הטעם ונשתנה הטבע בתירוסו יפה מאוד. So you responded, he's talking about the Mohel, right?
Mm-hmm.
That you said that the nature has changed. And the rabbi feels here that was a good explanation. אכן קצר מאוד ולא ביאר דבריו שלא יתפסוהו מתנגדי המסיסה בתנעתם שגם עתה נשתנה הטבע, right? But you were very short in your words, and you were very careful because you didn't want to get caught in your words. Is that what he's saying?
No, it's the opposite. But The problem is over here that you shortened your words too much.
Right.
But you didn't explain your words carefully enough, and you left yourself open. And because you didn't explain your words too, you know, carefully enough, there is a chance that you will get caught by those that are against the Mesisah, and they're going to say, well, if you could say back then, you know, nature changed, we're saying now nature has changed.
Right. Ashezehu amud semichata anatam. Because this is the pillar of their claim, right? And this is something that cannot be denied neither from our side. Because it is true that I guess nature has changed from the time of the Talmud to our time. But if what Ashaz Shebe Shabbat Vegitin Veyomayu Hehu, right, and the cures that appear in the Talmud on regard to Shabbat, to on
Masechet
Shabbat, right, in the Masechetot Shabbat, Gitin, Yoma, proves that, right? Uleman hisbir tiruso aniskar leer heetik lo bekesara, ma shekatu esli beinyan ze. Also, now he's going to explain his position on this. This is very interesting, right? He's going to explain, I guess, how it has changed. Mm-hmm. Nature has changed. Right, from the time of the Talmud to our times, right, on regard to these sicknesses. Ve'ithoro
ve'itlabenu ha'devarim be'ezrat Hashem. Everything will become crystal clear.
Right, tihor. Right, so everything will be clear. Right, beterem kol odi'ehu, and before everything I will let you know, ki ta'anat miknagedei ha'mesisa, מרית הרחיסה מראיית הרחיסה לא חדשה היא, right? And there,
the claim,
right? Against the Mesisa, right? It's nothing new.
So the proof of the Rechisa is not something new.
Mm-hmm. Right. וכבר הגאון בניין ציון. Who's this בניין ציון?
I'm going to look him up later, don't worry.
Okay.
I don't know how they tie in Rechisa with...
They're
using it because it's something that was done, and they got rid of it because there was no need for it.
Well, you're talking about something of washing someone as opposed to something to do with an open wound.
But
this
holds no ground.
Right. So already this book, Binyan Sion, he brought a response, right, on Siman 24. וויכוח שהיה לו עם הרב הגאון המנוח כבוד מורנו הרב רבי אליעזר הורוביץ זיכרונו לברכה אבי דין דקל קדוש ויין
ויין
Oh, this is Vienna.
Vine.
Hollywood and Vine.
Would you like some Vine? You like Manischewitz?
Right, so he had already a discussion with Binyan Sion, had a discussion with this an argument, I should say, with this Elazar Horowitz, right? He was the rabbi, the abedin of Vienna. וכנראה מדבריו שם שהרב הנזכר לאל היה ממתנגדיה. He was against what? Right, so it seems that
he was against the rabbi,
the rabbi of Vienna.
Yeah, Rabbi Horowitz.
Right, so he was really, so he wanted to be Mevatel. He wanted.
So it would seem, yes.
Asher mize yira kevodo shehiye asher paleta kulmuso shegaga begilayon dalet anizka leel shekara lebaale de'a zo kat reformit.
Oh, yes,
halila.
Reformed. You refer to when you over there as a reform, as the reform group.
Right, and so the rabbi doesn't agree that this is a reform position.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not proper to say so.
You can't just call them after all, like that. Right. You can't do that. You have to study it.
And we have to learn it. Behane Rabbanei Gedolei Israel. Shaklu v'tareu v'davar. These are the great rabbis of Israel. They investigated, they learned on these issues, right? They investigated the issues. Mavikach. V'sha'ane lashon amedubar. Im harofeim milashon amedubar im harabanim nochenefesh, right? And it is different, the language that's spoken on regard to the, when the doctors, they speak, right? And when the rabbis talk about it, it's a complete different type of language. Ki al ken, nale hasir halashon amuzar hahu. I don't know what this is.
Vidai baze.
Oh, vidai baze, okay. Right? Right.
Oh, sorry. Not vidai baze, vidai bar bet. Vidai bar sheni. Over here.
Oh, this is vidai bar sheni?
I think so. I'm pretty sure.
Okay. Right. So anyway, he didn't like his the way. I mean, there's a difference in approach in between the doctors and in between the hachamim. Right. Sheharav anizkar leel katab ezeleshono im bizman haMishnah hashvu haMesisa lesorech gadol. If during the time of the Mishnah they thought of the Mesisa as something really needed, veshiyesh sakana bechidul ota. Right. And if the, and that there is danger if we stop doing it, וְחַרְכָּה בִּתְּלָה בְּיָדֵיהֶם שֶׁאֵין עוֹד סַכָּנָה, and then afterwards it was nullified with their knowledge that there is no any further thought of it being of it having any danger, right? Or שֶׁלֹא הָיָה סַכָּנָה גַּם אַז, right? Or that if there was any danger during the, their time, מַדּוּעַ לֹא נֵאמַר כֵּן בְּדָבָר הַמְסִיסָה כָּן עַד כָּן לְשֹׁנוֹ. Or כֵּן, right? I'm sorry, כֵּן, right? Why isn't it said?
The problem, there's a mistake. You have to go back. Shah, okay, go back to Imbizman HaMishnah, you see?
Imbizman HaMishnah.
Hashbu HaRihisa.
Right, because I was right.
That's Rihisa. Imbizman HaMishnah, Hashbu HaRihisa, that's what it did all. If they thought that this washing was something that was greatly needed, they thought there was a sakana with them not doing it. And afterward, Batla. They stopped it. Biyodam shein ol sakana. They stopped it because they found that there is no more sakana.
Right.
Oh, shalahayas sakana gamaz. There was no sakana at the time. Madu alon omar gam b'dvar hamesisa ken. What can we say that regarding mesisa? Al ken shono. Ba'azeh shibigayom min yensiyon zikron lebrachav zid shono min bitul arihisa en raya al mesisa. You cannot compare one thing to the next, right, Ronnie?
Right.
Thank you.
שמסוגיה לשבת, דף קוף למדלת, ממה שפליג, הוא, ממה שפליג רבע, אם תנא כמה הוא זה רבע, בלעזר בן עזריה, אם תנא כמה, אוקיי, אם יש צורך להרחיס ביום השלישי או לא, if they're in to wash on Tuesday, אוקיי, יום שלישי או not, וממד פליגי אמוראי, אם מרחיסין ומזלפין, do we wash or we just sprinkle the water, ואם מותר הרחסת כל גופו, או הרחסת מילה לבד, okay, if we're permitted to wash the whole body, or just wash the מילה only, נראה שדבר רחיסה, לא היה דבר פשוט מקובל אסלאם. It seems that the issue of the washing of the רחיסה was not a simple matter and fully accepted by them. אלא שידענו בה, they judged it, they studied it, על פי מה שהיה נראה להם סורך לפי שינוי הטבעים, based upon what they saw, you know, was worked with the times. ולכן, דן בית יוסף, שאחרי שידוע אצלנו שאין סכנה בביטול רחיסה, and since we know there's no סכנה by annulling this רחיסה, אסור לחדש שבת עליה. We cannot be מחדש שבת because of רחיסה. שהרי גם זמן המשנה והגמרא, לא הייתה רחיסה רפואה מקוימת וברורה לכל אופניה. It was not a fully recognized and accepted medical practice on all, you know, from all angles. אבל איך נדון כזה על המסיסה שאין בה פנוקתה? I can show. But how is it the same thing about the mesisa that you cannot compare one to the other, like Ronnie was saying before?
Right, right, right.
Correct? Now you feel good?
I feel much better about it, yeah.
Good.
Good?
Yeah.
Yalla, chabot, yalla, Rabbi, let's see if you're going.
Unbelievable. Okay. Right, so, but this is Rabbi Horowitz, right? Who, oh no, this is Ben Etzion, I'm sorry.
Yes, he's going to Ben Etzion at the end of here. You want to know who the Ben Etzion is? You keep reading, I'll find you Ben Etzion. I'll find out who he is.
Venoraot nifleti al divrei kodesho, and I was much surprised on your holy words, on his holy words. Velo yadati ma teshuvahi zod lidhot reaya harechisa. And I did not understand what type of a proof was this, to push away the proof of the rechisa. שלא הייתה סכנה מקוימת וברורה ממה זה פליגת הנאה והמוראה בדינה, that it wasn't a clear סכנה, since the rabbis of the תנאים and the מוראים are arguing on this issue, והלא תלמודנו מלא על כל גדותיו ממין זה, the פליגת הנאה והמוראה בדין. Isn't the whole, the entire Talmud full of all these arguments between the תנאים and the אמוראים? זה אומר וכו, וזה אומר ההפך, right? One rabbi says something, and the other rabbi contradicts him. ואחר כך ההלכה תכריע. And then the ההלכה finally outweighs the opinions. ועל פי ההלכה יקום דבר לעולם בתורתנו, and according to the ההלכה, that's how we follow the Torah. ובדין הרחיסה, מי הווה? אי פליגי רבי אלעזר בן עזריה עם רבנן במשנה, ואחר כך פליגי המוראה ביישוב דברי המשנה. In regard to that argument between רבי אלעזר בן עזריה and the חכמים of the משנה, and afterwards the argument between the המוראים to understand the words of the משנה, הלא אחר כך באותו דף עצמו הפסיקה. I don't have this word. What's halacha? Right? Isn't it right after that we find that the halacha was decided? The amar Rabbi Yohanan halacha ki Rabbi Elazar ben Azaria. Right? That's what Rabbi Yohanan concluded. The halacha is like Rabbi Elazar ben Azaria. That what's his position?
Marhisin et akatan ben Bechamim ben Shabbat ben Shabbat ben Shabbat ben Shabbat ben Hasad Gufor ben Hasad Milam ben Shazakana Hilo Ni'uyan
Shem. So do we wash the child, right?
We wash the child in right. hot water whether the water was heated on Shabbat
or Erev Shabbat
or Erev Shabbat,
right.
Whether we're washing the entire body or just the Milah,
and that's because of the second
Tera.
If in Pasku Aposkim Arif Arambam Harosh Ve'atur V'chol Noseh Kelehem, all of these rabbis put together with their commentators,
they all say the same halakha, the Rif, the Rambam, the Rosh, the Tur, etc.
Ve'im kem sakanat al-hisan yisekah lehalakha al-ma'aseh. Right, so then the issue of this danger of the rehisa, right, it was halakha, an acting halakha. We did this halakha, this the way we fulfilled the halakha. Uma yesh yoter reaya shehi refuah beduka. And what more proof that this is a proven cure? Berura umekuyemet besakana lehadol mimena, and it's clear, and it's practiced, and it's actually dangerous to do away with it. Mima shehutar lehalel aleha Shabbat. Ahamura, you see that we are ready to break Shabbat, right? That for this purpose, the menacha gemura deoraita lehem ma'im Shabbat, on something that is absolutely menacha, right? From the Torah to boil water on Shabbat. If so, velama harav zikrono libracha lamad mi. He's saying that from the arguments of the Talmud, and not from the conclusion, and it's incredible. It's unbelievable that it is. That's how he concluded. Mis sevarot divrei de mis sevarot lamad mis sevara the Talmudin.
Where did
you go? I'm just trying to figure that mem samach damit.
Oh.
Yeah, but Misov Davar doesn't sound right.
Doesn't
fit. The Talmudim.
The Matnitin. Shulkat Amata Sa'adad Ishmaya. Mishayim Tam. Fek Rusa. Fekat Abayta. Shabit Devarim. Yimta. Shulkat Abukana.
Misafek Devarav the Talmudim. Misafek Divrei the Talmudim.
I don't know.
No, it's got to be something like that. The idea is that over there is no maskana yet.
Mm-hmm.
And you go and you make the conclusion from the arguments.
And then, not from the maskana. Mezve pele. And this is, we wonder. Ve'odet pale al ha-gaon, zikrono livracha. And further, we wonder about this great rabbi of blessed memory. If this wasn't a clear cure in their days for the rabbis, how did they allow breaking Shabbat on something that they were doubting? Right? So, on regard, we learn in Masechet Yuma, In page 83, on regard to a man that was bitten by a dog, shote.
Shote is a wild dog.
Right, it's a wild dog. Shirabanan oserim
lehachilo. Well, we don't know if it's rabbi or not, but we'll have to guess so.
Yeah, they don't know. So it's just one of his.
Shirabanan oserim lehachilo mehasar kaved shelo. Rav Matia ben Haraz matir. So,
Be'achilo me'hasar kaved shelo.
I wonder if it's the dog himself. But this is a cure.
Well, obviously it's a cure.
Right, and it comes right from the liver. But it's probably from the dog.
Somebody that a wild dog bit it.
Right.
Shirabanan osim ha'achilo ma'hasar kevid shelo. The rabbis forbid to feed him from that portion of his liver.
From the dog, probably.
Obviously from the dog.
Right.
Vibat ya ben haras meti. But this Abu Rabbi is meti. Even though this may be a medical treatment that the rabbis, the medical profession
right.
considers it a tried and tested formula,
right.
this is not something that we can, you know, do to allow him to eat forbidden meat. That's what he's saying over here. Obviously, we know that a wild dog bites a person. Like you said, very possible it is a rabbit, and of course, it could be extremely dangerous. It could be deathly. مخرحين نحن نمار شهي سكنا بالوراء من حزرة كشياء من أكديها من سيصال القماء لما شنا من الحساش بالتلوها
Right. So he just knocked it.
What did he say?
Explain to David how he knocked it out.
He says, therefore, you see in the case of the dog, right, that we don't know if that's a real cure. The Hachamim didn't allow him to be fed this kaved, this liver from the dog, right? Even though we know that it's dangerous.
Let's say it's a rabid dog. We'll call it a rabid dog, to just understand it better.
Right? It's just because we don't know that this is really cures the person, right? This liver.
I thought they knew that. No, we don't know.
They're not sure. Even though people do it, we don't consider it.
What do they do?
They fed him the liver.
The liver of that same dog.
To who?
To the guy that got bit.
He got bit by the dog. He's a wild dog.
The same liver.
Rabbit
they
dog.
Gave him the liver for some reason. They figured that.
So they thought that would cure him, but it wasn't something that they. I'm sorry, it wasn't something that they had really tested and they could say that it was for sure. So therefore they said you can't give him to eat.
Because it's forbidden meat.
Right. And so if in something like that they didn't allow for us to be to use it because out of a safek, out of a doubt if it really cures. Right, on Shabbat we got Isur Sekila or Charet,
it's how much more so should we deal with the right? That they wouldn't allow it. Should have a little bit of what right?
Say it again.
If they didn't know that this thing cured, how much more so that they would not have allowed us to use it, right, to cure the babies like that. So therefore, we have to conclude that this is absolutely sakana, that the babies must be washed, right? Therefore, you have no proof from the washing of the right, of the baby to the issue of Mezizah.
دخل في زمران بيت يوسف حوليك على البوتين وشهيم أبو شيس كنا ما نحن وما شاها خامين ويوتر بيه حكام يوتر بيه بيدو عن إذاع شئين بسكنا في زمران بزمان الشاس حللو شباد وصول حليل بحاس حاس من الهسكير هو مش كتب مران هو هيدانا دون أهاجنو بريحي سكيلال براض من الحاج بينهم كما يتلاها معايير بيد بيهجاؤون زمران برخاس ريحيون so now what is it over here? Now we know that we have Maran, and you're saying that Maran says that since we already know that there's no sakana, you know, in Bitul Rahisan, asur to the Halal Shabbat. Says, please, sir, these words were never uttered by Maran.
Absolutely.
Never happened, because if Maran said that, that means he is Hulik, he is
right.
Going against all the words of our Hachamim that says there's sakana. And we're going to say that we are smarter, you know, that Maran is smarter than all of them? We can't say that. And we're going to say, if we're going to say that, then it's like saying that we know Torah better than the Hachamim of the Gemara, and the Hachamim of the Gemara were Mehallel Shabbat,
right.
And we are not. Has Menazkir. Perish the thought. We can't utter such a thing. What did Maran write? He said, Ha'idana, nowadays. We don't have the custom of Rehisa Kilal. There's a big difference between saying we don't have the custom of Rehisa and Maran said that, you know, there's no sakana, so we don't do it. Okay? And this needs, obviously, to look into as to why such a thing was said.
There is a difference. That's a difference.
A tremendous difference.
Why washing it?
What? No.
Not at all. Let's keep going, though. We have to unravel this issue, he's saying. The Yan Rahisa, the Sakanata, the Hayubah Muskabashas, the issue of Rahisa and the danger involved and the obligation that is mentioned in the Shas. This is not an issue for the entire nation, for all generations, like one of our statutes and laws of the religion. This is an issue for places that are already accustomed to it. And them being used to it is like second nature. At the time in the Gemara time of Talmud, it was so, you know, such a common thing, they didn't think otherwise. And know that this is the way it is. Shaharina bin Harambam, which you know from bin Harambam, the Rabbi Bracha. Bebadil sok din ha rehisa b'shabbat. When you come to deal with this issue of Pesach din, of rehisa b'shabbat. Pesach bin chut mila, perik bed, din hayat, b'zeh the shono. Makom, shedarkan, rehisa katan. In the place where there's the custom to wash the katan, they wash him.
Oh.
And he didn't come down and posek with a sharp knife, like the wording of the shas, no, you must wash the baby. No, if there's a custom in the place, then you do it. If not, not. In the same style of words, katab haran. He read the varam haran, a case of Mishneh Sham. And we found the words of the Ran in Maran, the case of Mishneh, in the commentary of Maran on the Mishneh Torah. Umizener e barur, the Harambam, the Torah of the Bracha, sover, the e dinarehisa, hok ba'uma. According to the Rambam, we understand that this is not a hok, this is not a law for the entire nation. Rakadabar talui behedgel, ubizmano lohaya hadabar murga bechot for Israel. This is something you could tell from the Harambam's words, that this is not something that was the accepted practice and custom in his place and time. In places where they did not have the custom of doing it, they're not accustomed to doing it. Obviously you cannot say that the prevention of it and not doing it is something that is dangerous. It will be forbidden for them to wash on Shabbat. And according to my opinion, my understanding, this is how Maran came up with his wording. He saw from the time of Rambam, which was approximately 320 years prior to his days, the custom already began to falter. Ubizman Maran, at the time of Maran, Kabar Aba Kalah Al Minhag Val King Kadab Dahidanu Kedal. Already he saw that nobody was doing it whatsoever, and therefore he wrote, Dahidana, nowadays, no Nahu Kedal. Nobody does it whatsoever.
But if you do it?
If you do it, what? If you do it based upon what?
If based not, upon the rabbis of the Gemara, the Mishnah. If you do
no,
it based upon them.
But you look at the. Because in the time of the Gemara, in the place of the Gemara, okay, in Surah, in Humpadita, in Habda'a, in these areas, this was the custom because that's what they thought in the place and the time. But if it is not the custom of the place and the time, the people aren't accustomed to it, you don't do it. This is what Haram Bob told
you,
this is what Haram told you.
Just something done at the time.
That's
because
it.
Because you had a danger
so now,
then.
Now it's just lending credence to the fact that these two things are totally Rechitza and then it's
have nothing to do with it. Exactly.
So far away from each other that the
as far as the difference between east and west.
Point out ludicrous. It's,
exactly. They're basically stumbling upon their own feet. You don't have the issue at hand. You don't have the sakana. The sakana was only in their mind, really. Hello, today, she was not a shas. You'll see the time of the Gemara. Haita, sikha, the one murgab. Sikha, we know it's something that's asur on Kippur, no sikha. You can't do sikha. It's translated to us as anointing, you know. We can't rub creams and stuff on it. We don't do these things. By the time of the Gemara, we see it all over the place. He's telling you, sikha. The one murgab was something that was very, very, you know, commonplace. If you wash and you didn't do sach and you didn't anoint yourself as well, you are considered, as if you are water on the face of the barrel. You know, you didn't finish the job, you know.
What is it, like oil or something?
Yeah.
Or if cologne is not considered anything like
no.
that?
No. No.
Okay.
Not the way they did it. They did it. It was such a commonplace thing that everybody used to do. They took it to be one of the five, five ways of afflicting oneself that became a custom on Kippur and Tisha B'Av.
Wow.
What sikha do we have? What inuya then? Kippur comes, we don't eat, we don't wash, we don't wear leather shoes, we don't have marital relations. Sikha? What sikha?
Yeah.
Nobody
yeah.
does anything.
Yeah.
It's just, okay, it's one of the five things. What is it? Nobody knows. Nobody does anything. We have with bloodletting. Okay, people mm-hmm. used to do bloodletting all the time. Shayyab is man the barn it was a wondrous item. Shayyu makizim minnu kodam. Oh, the people used to suck. They take leeches and suck out their blood.
Isn't that similar to?
To what?
The Mezizah?
Yeah. No, they were doing it for different issues. They were doing
no, different issues.
No,
but
yeah.
It
yeah.
has the same.
Same
know,
what?
Like reasoning behind
correlation,
it.
Even
sucking yeah. out the bad blood or,
right,
or the infection out of the body.
No.
It was done.
Yeah, it sucked out the bad blood.
No, they were doing it
more
it's not
to
a mezizah, it's, well, actually, the bug is doing
it. You're doing the mezizah, sure. Yeah. But yeah. Believers doing it. I'm just drinking away, let me tell you.
Interesting.
They were doing it for different things. Hakazah seems to have been one of the most common forms of dealing with blood pressure.
Oh, was it a blood pressure issue?
That was, they thought they're pulling out infection, but really, you know, from what, when you read these ancient, you know, books about it, what they were doing when people didn't feel good, and the symptoms, you could tell them.
High blood pressure. Interesting. I didn't know that.
No, they didn't do also for infections. Like George Washington, wasn't he had an infection? So they went and they sucked out blood and blood and blood until he died.
I really don't know.
George Washington.
You don't know how he died?
No, I don't know how he died. How did he die?
He had an infection or something, and he started taking out blood, and he just kept taking out blood until they took out a couple of pints, and he died because he was too weak.
But they took out blood how? With leeches?
Yeah, bloodletting. The bloodletting way.
No, but they had bloodletting, and not even with leeches. What they did was bloodletting is that they actually just, you know, sliced the vein and just let the blood seep out. They were doing that
also. I gotcha. Maybe too much came out.
Yeah it's kind of like...
That was
a really smart thing for them to do.
Maybe they were doing it on purpose. Maybe.
Somebody. Martha didn't like them.
It was really his father getting back to him from the cherry tree.
Yeah.
I hope we have this all day, let me tell you.
It's all on tape. Okay, so they're
bringing... ויחד מסבעין הקזה שהיה בזמן הדבר נפלא שהיו מקיזים ממנו כל דם ומניעים בו רק וביעיד דם כדי חיות הנפש. They just suck out practically 3/4 of their blood and only leave 1/4 of their blood in them. Mm. You know, until for the blood to regenerate itself and, you know, rebuild the, you know.
Blood. Yeah.
His hero would have blamed the bracha, the echov, the shot, yain had beer, they told him, make sure you eat and drink a lot of wine. But you'll have kazata. On the day that you do the bloodletting, make sure you eat a lot and make sure you drink a lot of wine because you want to, you know, re-nourish your body. Yeah. כמו שראה המעיין בשבת, אני עושה את הגמרא, מסכת שבת, קוף כ"ט. כמה אזהרו וסיבויים על ככה עד שאמרו שהמקל בסעודת הכזה, somebody who is leaned with the סעודת הכזה, מכירים לו מסעודתם לשמיים. The שמיים also is going to be lenient with you as how much food they're going to give you throughout the year. That's what the Gemara talks about.
Wow.
It was such a big thing at that time.
Yeah.
וכן יוסי, and similar items. ומותר להחלה עליו את השבת.
אם
נסתנן. And if you get a cold, you know, from, because you let out so much blood, now you're going to cold, you know, you're going to get a cold from it. Mm-hmm. And you could be מחלה שבת because of that. אפילו בתקופת תמוז, even בתקופת תמוז, in the middle of the summer. Mm-hmm. ובזמן הזה, the hottest time of the summer, say, the summer solstice.
Yeah.
ובזמן הזה, אין לנו כזה כזו ולא סכנה יותר. We don't have a כזה, we don't have סכנה, we don't have anything like this. ואנחנו יכולים לומר, שאין בה סכנה, ומאחר שלא הורגלנו בה, לא נדע לא תעליותיה ולא מחרביה ונזקיה. We cannot say that there's no סכנה, because we are not accustomed to it. We do not know the actions of it, we don't know the pains of it, we do not know the, you know, the damage that it can cause. כדלו של דבר אני אומר. In summary, what I'm saying, שכל דבר שנעשה להן לו טבע, מחמת הרגיל, sometimes it becomes nature of them because they are accustomed to it more, אם כן, עתה בזמננו, ששר ההרגיל חדל להיות טבעי, because we're not used to it, it's not our nature nowadays, מכיוון שכן, because of such, הרחיסה והשיחה והכזה, שאין כאן דבר שטבע התודה יחיבהו, ורק הרגל עשהו לטבע בזמנם, and only because they were accustomed to it and became nature in the time, אם כן בזמן הזה, שחדלו מהרגל, since nowadays we don't have, we are unaccustomed to it, והוא אין כאן סכנה, there's no סכנה, שבסור הסיבה, יוסר המסובב. If you don't have, you know, the mitigating factor, then nothing's going to happen. וזהו מה שכתב מהר"ן, זכרונו לברכה, בדין הרחיסה, דהי דנה לא נהגו בו. But don't do it nowadays, that's all. Betulo. He didn't say any more, any less. We don't want to say any more. He didn't say there's no sakana. It's still the Botan Sokham Recha. He didn't come to go against the words of the Hakamim. Shim Gem Ata If nowadays we were accustomed to it as in their times, who would say there's no sakana? We're not accustomed to it. So if we're not accustomed to it, then we don't have the danger of it. Right? If you don't do something, you can't have the danger. Okay, and it's crystal clear, basically. Based upon what I've said, I do not see how you could even imagine there is any sort of similarity between the Rehisa and the Mesisa. Sham Mesisa, she will see her dam in Mekomot Rehokim, she will eat lehe, Mekomot Pesa, Mekayose, who the word Tibi. This is an act of nature. That something happens. Betul Deh, Tol Shel Adam. This happens on the person's body. She will eat Shunet Tibah, Tol Deh, Adam. Person is going to stay person forever. Okay, human being, from the time Adam had Ishon until the end of the world. The human body is not changing. Which is different than nature, which is really second nature that comes to you from being used to doing something.
Right.
That doesn't change your body the way Borei Olam created. Right. One thing is one thing, this is a different thing. Once you stop being accustomed to it, then it's not nature anymore. This is the nature of the Rehisa. Since we don't do it, there's no sakana. Ha'umnam. عنينها مسيسا هو دوار قيام بالتبع تولداش كأشي يحتاج بصر الدم عدول ما كون البيس إذا هي بعد يديه حمد دم right away if you cut yourself the area is going to become inflamed because of the heat of the blood ومسيسات ما كون حتى هي فوته by sucking that area this is the way for treating it بخيسات يسويات بسخر إن وشين ومار and how can you put such an image into your mind نوما شعتا شنوها التبعيم The nature has changed and there's no need for it. Nowadays, if you cut your skin, blood's not going to come out? Of course it's going to come out. Oh, im gam ki nimsos adam shel makom hanach no yisa adam migida ve'orkav ki nishana teva if you're going to suck the blood's not going to come pulling away from the inner parts? Of course it's going to. Hello? Somebody who says such a thing, you consider crazy. The guy's nuts, you know. To save the child from imminent danger. It's our obligation to do it. And we cannot sway from doing the Mesisah.